Hi there, welcome back to Creator on Wheels. I hope you guys are doing absolutely happy and healthy. Yeah, there's not much option left. Things are becoming worse day by day, so being happy and being healthy is the only option now. It's a Saturday today. I've been just going out for a short coffee ride. To be more precise, no breakfast or no lunch or dinner ride, it's a coffee ride. Came out now because I don't know if it will be possible to go out tomorrow. Starting today, there is apparently a night curfew, night lockdown kind of a thing, which means until 5 o'clock, you're not supposed to go out at 5 in the morning. I mean, not that I would have gone out at 5 in the morning, but still, that would mean that all those who wanted to start early will start late, and that would mean the road will be slightly crowded, which is something which I don't prefer or like. And again, morning rides are synonymous with places being crowded again. So trying out something new by going out in the evening. I've gone few times in the past, just gone out for like about 30-40 kilometers, had a nice coffee and come back. Heading on the Hyderabad road, the airport road to be more precise, probably will ride till Chikbalapur and stop over at that hotel or restaurant which I went, I think, about a month ago. It's called Cube Stop. They apparently had a nice coffee when I went there for breakfast a few weeks back. So plan is to have coffee, take some rest and come back. That's all. What it is all reduced to now. Not much option due to the increasing COVID cases. Traveling is still something which I'm taking a second thought. And moreover, it's summer. It's terribly hot. Whatever you say about Bangalore weather, beautiful and all, the summer here are very hot. So probably we'll stick to doing some of these short evening rides to keep the bike running and all. But the proper ride will start, I don't know when. Proper traveling, I mean. Anyway, let's see how the situation goes, how bad it will become, how good it will become. It's just that you have to be safe, you have to be careful. That's it. That's all you can do. So the hot topic of discussion over the last 1 week in this whole two-wheeler riding community or the touring community, or more so specifically in the motor vlogging community, is this untimely passing away of the person from Andhra Pradesh, the motor vlogger. So a lot of people are talking about it. Was it right, was it not right, and all those stuff. I mean, I'm pretty sure, like, I think all of them are telling what he did was totally wrong. And that's not required. Okay, now for the people who don't know what exactly happened. So there is this specific guy who was out in Spiti. He was riding back. And he was heading towards Andhra. So he kind of set out a challenge for himself or whatever, where he wanted to create a record of riding continuously all the way from north until Andhra. I mean, like, whatever, the few thousand kilometers. I mean, who asked him to set up that record, or like, who is keeping a track of all these records? Just because few popular motor vloggers or few experienced motor vloggers are able to do something doesn't mean that everyone should go and attempt it. And it's not just about whether your bike is capable, it's also about you as a person. Are you capable of doing it? Again, it depends on the type of vehicle, the type of mindset. You already finished a trip, you already finished like some 15-20 days of a Spiti trip, and you want to do this one. Your body is not ready for it. And look at the weather. Like, I mean, here in Bangalore itself, the 35, 36 that we are having is unbearable. And now you're talking about passing through central India and heading towards Andhra. and doing like a endurance run. It was not required. So though it's not really, the news is not clear whether what really happened in the last few moments, but it's for sure, one thing is clear, that he's apparently hit the divider. He's lost the control of his bike, he's hit the divider, and he's died. A lot of disturbing visuals are available on the social media, on YouTube, on Instagram, and all those things. I don't want to post or share any of them here in this video. But I've heard, or like I've seen at least, five or six videos in the last 1 week, all from very popular motor vloggers and people who are into touring, motorcycle touring and all. Everyone is telling the only one thing: don't chase all these records and all those stuff. Like, nobody is asking you to do 1,000 kilometers in 10 hours or whatever, like overnight riding and stressing yourself, racing and all those things. I'm pretty sure nobody is keeping a track of all these records, so it is not required. This is not competitive racing, which happens on track, or something which happens like Dakar, wherein it's like you just have to keep riding. It's a different thing altogether. You want to really do competitive racing, go to tracks or go to participate in rallies. Not doing it on public roads, and don't risk your life, don't risk others' life. Okay, here in this case, this one person met with an accident, he passed away. Just imagine the amount of trauma that his family is going through right now. Now, looking at this, how many people will be like disturbed by this whole, the whole touring community and all this? Like, they'll be like really disturbed with whatever is happening. I mean, as I told you in the last video, I think I made a very specific video about this just a week or two back. It's definitely not about you being prepared and your bike being perfect, which is having the best possible brakes and best possible tires and all those things. It is also about what is happening around you. I mean, just see what happened with the person Matt Pirates when he was riding in Kerala. He was not racing at 100-150. Okay, and the same is the case with Sir Richard. He was not racing, he was not even like close to even that, and he is like a person who's done the world tour, and he knows his bike in and out, and he knows what he is doing and what he is not doing. These are not the type of people who go ahead and do mistake by doing rash riding. It's about the situation. In one case, a cow or a buffalo came in the way of a super bike. In another case, a camel came in the way of an adventure tourer bike. Well, in both the cases, the end result was pathetic. We can't get them back. We can't get these guys back. Here also, we don't know what really happened. I don't know if the accident happened in the night or during the day, but it's not clear whether something like a dog came in the way or something like that. But for sure, it's like these type of endurance things are not required. And especially, as I told you, after doing like a week or two of a Spiti trip, and in that challenging weather, that extremely challenging weather of Spiti, cold, and the terrain itself is like different. You finish and come that, and you want to do an endurance run on a plain road and in like hot 35 plus degree temperature, it's not required, man. Like, be sensible when you're out to do something like this. As I told, like, care about your own safety, your own life, and also about other people who are there on the road. And all this is like, it might look fun recording all these things on a motor vlog and putting it on YouTube and all those things, but now who will get back his life? Which video? Does this video getting like a million views bring him back to life? No. Just please don't try to imitate other moto vloggers. Okay, if you really want to do it in their style of talking, do it in their way of presenting them, do it, imitate them with their intros and outros and all those things, but not with this right kind of a risk. So that's all. I mean, like, I don't know if I would like really prepare to talk something about it, but like last 1 week, the more I hear from people who are very, very well experienced in this whole touring community, and they expressing their thoughts on this, it becomes evident that the newer guys are becoming more and more careless. It's all that instantaneous fame that, okay, I do something like this, put it on YouTube or Instagram, become famous. Please avoid doing this. Please, please, please avoid doing this. Take care of yourself, take care of your health, take care of your life, take care of the lives of the people around you, your own family members, your friends, and the people who are there on the road. Don't do such things. That's all I want to say. I mean, I don't know if I really want to emphasize anything that are like, I would say like definitely a double digit number of videos that are already there on the web talking about this. Probably I'll try to list a few of them here in the description as well. Some of them which I've seen, some of them whom I've been following religiously. And you can actually go through that. Like, you can get perspectives, what the senior touring guys tell about it, what the senior motovlogging folks talk about it. But that's all I want to say. Take care, guys. Don't do all this competitive racing on public roads and doing all this endurance stuff and all this. So that's what I want to tell. Thank you so much for listening. I'll catch you later. Bye bye. Matte sigana.